Now, I always like to start out with an inventory of the concepts that are going to be used. So far we have the notion of a pattern or a regular expression, of a text to match against, of a result, which will also be a string of some kind. And it doesn't seem like there's all that many more concepts. One thing that it looks like we'll need is some notion of a partial result and some notion of control over the iteration. And what do I mean by that? Well, some of the matches are easy. If we match search for a literal DEF within ABC DEF, it's easy to imagine just going down the line of this string and saying, does it match here? No. Here? No. Here? No. Here? Yes. So we'll return the result. But what if we're matching with the pattern? Let's say we have the expression A star B plus, any number of A's followed by one or more B, and in our API notation, we would write that as the sequence of star of literal A plus of literal B. And let's say we're matching that against the string A, 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 B. Now, if we had a control structure that says sequence look to match the first and then look at the second, and if the first star of literal A only had one possible result, then it would say, yes, it matches here right at the start. Now I'll look for something after that. Does it match plus of literal B? No, it doesn't. So I've got to have iteration over the possible results. I have to say that star of literal A can match in more than one location. It can match with zero instances of A, with one, with two, with three, and it's only after three that then we can match the second part, find the B, and then find that the whole expression matches. So that's going to be the tricky part, is worrying about this control when one part of a sequence doesn't match, or similarly when we have an alternative between two possibilities, A or B, or alternative of AB. So this trickiness seems like it's going to be difficult, but it all resolves itself after we make one good choice and take some experience to see what that choice can be. But if we decide to represent these partial results as a set of remainders of the text, then everything falls into place. What do I mean by a remainder? I mean everything else after the match. So if we match a literal A, the remainder, if after we match zero characters of this string, would be A, three A's followed by a B. The remainder after we match one A would be two A's followed by a B, and so on. And so what I'm going to do is define an auxiliary function called matchSet, and it takes a pattern and a text, and it returns this set of remainders. And so when given just this pattern here as the input, star of literal A, and this text as the text, then the remainder would be a set consisting of three A's and a B, two A's and a B, one A and a B, or just B. In other words, star of little A could have consumed 0, 1, 2, or 3 A's, and that's the remainder that's left over. And so the result will be this set.